last time we were on this planet, and we had this like beacon come up, and we followed the beacon, and then we went to this planet, and there were, and the beacon said there was some life signs, and it led me to here, and unfortunately my hard drive filled up. I wasn't keeping an eye on it, so I lost just 5 minutes of the recording. There was a gentleman in here who gave me a blueprint for a hyperdrive, because if you remember, it was this gentleman here, who's very nice. If you remember, my ship doesn't have one. As I say, if I do a lot of that, I'll do it off camera. Because, you know, I don't just want to stand there mining for half an hour. I'd rather do the exploration and stuff like that. I don't mind doing little bits of it, but life support. We have attached to a ship, because it does seem that I kind of get one and then 2 episodes later I've got a new one. Let's sell this gold. That's 36,000, which is not bad, is it? Right, we want to buy some iridium. I'm going to buy all your iridium. Of this planet, then we can space station. I love the aesthetics of this. It's absolutely gorgeous. Sell it and then buy it. It might cost us a few things, but yeah, it did cost us like 6,000 units. Typical earning units, sell valuable and rare items at galactic trade terminals. Right, let's see if we can't install this hyperdrive. Bizarrely, it doesn't have carbon here. Oh well. Okay, we need to fuel the hyperdrive. How do we fuel the hyperdrive? We need a warp cell. Collect a warp cell. Can we buy a warp cell? That's nice, that red one there. That's like a proper. We've seen those ones before. I know, you come back on into. Well, we've seen you before. To be honest with you, that is a bit like a kind of motorhome type thing. That's a nice ship though, I wouldn't mind getting one of those. So how do we get antimatter? Starship scanner. Maybe it's going to tell me that antimatter's on like a planet somewhere. Oh, okay. Let's leave the space station, I guess. I love the launch sequence of this. Incoming signal detected. Ah, okay. What do we got here then? I'm guessing this person follows signal to return to life form. It's going to help me out possibly with the antimatter. So I think because I actually I don't have any infantry space to on my ship. One for us to. Yeah, we could actually do all of them, so. Oh, sorry about that. So we should actually dismantle this because it's worse than that one. That one gives us plus two, that one gives us plus one. There you go. And I'll collect some thalmium on my way. So I think because we kind of got a ship with a hyperdrive really early without doing any of this, it kind of like skipped the tutorial, but then I didn't know how to do the I don't know how to get the warp cell to power it, so good. I quite like the kind of I like the kind of management you need to do between like the infantry space, you know, whether or not you want to make enhancements to your ship or have infantry space to trade things, stuff like that. Here we go, back on this planet, back where we started. And back saying hello to our friend over here. Interact the maximum. privacy that you have got. And I can't seem to understand anything you're saying. The small, shiny-eyed creature is the only inhabitant of the building. We do not share a tongue, but it's evident that my companion would prefer not to be here, as before he relays a message to me. Once again sent by whoever Nada and Polo are. The staccato missive is accompanied by a donation of antimatter from my mysterious benefactor, enough of it that I could fabricate a warp cell for my hyperdrive. Well. I'm no wiser as to who Nada and Polo are, but now I have the means to locate them, though I strongly suspect that I must choose. I think what it's saying is I have to choose between the Atlas path and the Nada and Polo path. Down the Nada and Polo path. I don't know what that involves, really. I don't know what any of them involve. But I'm also not going to rush anything. But I believe we can craft now a warp cell. So let's get into space. And then, okay. Then we need to activate our hyperdrive. Open galactic map in space by pressing down. Okay, so we did this before, but we didn't know what on earth it was. So this is where we currently are. Four planets and one moon, which we've been to. Yes, we can. Okay, it's got four planets and two moons. Why not? Oh, wow. Okay. So we're in hyperspace now, apparently. Travelling to another system. Now, of course, I can always go back to that other system. Although I don't know how much fuel that just used. Oh my goodness, look at this planet. Things. Hello, I'm friendly. So we need to craft more antimatter. Acquire antimatter formula. Craft antimatter. Hey, how's it going, guys? Wow, that's a pretty mean looking ship. I'm gonna give you that. I am very excited about that planet down there. And I'm also quite excited about that giant boulder. Stunning. Oh, that looks rocky to me from here. But this planet here, this looks spectacular. I'm definitely going there. This looks like it's water-based and I've got that. Oh wow, yeah, look, it's like islands. Oh wow. Here, but I would not be doing myself hasn't got any. Okay, we don't know Corvax word. Interesting. Is this a Corvax system? What's that? What did that just do? Stand at the terminal, watch a beacon from unknown star endlessly play itself out on the screen. The pattern seems clear, but what to enter? So 8273, right? I just have a location within the distant stars. Okay. Oh wow, I'm really excited about this world. This looks awesome. We found a ruin over there, so that's cool. Okay. We could potentially craft a bypass chip and scan. Let's do that. I think I'd like to find some sort of outpost. Assuming that my ship cannot this thing. Oh wow. Now it's starting to. Vegetarian. They eat vegetation. Just pushed a bit out, get the oxygen back up. Oh my. Well, this is, certainly an interesting planet. understand that, you know, everybody has different tastes in games, but I don't think people can. I find it strange that people can kind of not say that this game is remarkable. It has its faults, but there's something quite special about it though. Understand that some people, it's just not their cup of tea, but you cannot deny that this is, what the hell are those things? Yeah, I think anyway, like an incredibly exciting game. The sound as you go underwater. Hey guys, how's it going? I don't have any iron, otherwise I would feed him. Oh god, what the hell is that thing? Oh my god, that is ugly as hell. It's passive though. Also, one thing I found out as well is that the planets have different day-night cycles. So some of them may have very long day-night cycles, some of them may have quite short ones. Which is obviously kind of realistic as to its position within the solar system, but also very cool. And also, you know, some animals may only come out at night, some may only come out during the day. chrysonite. I don't know if I need that, so I'm going to take it just in case. Oh, yeah, we can analyze this. That's very pretty. Go back to our ship. Word for warning. So this, I take it, is like Corvax space. That's why these settlements look a little bit different as well. Which is interesting. And there's a knowledge stone up there as well. Also, is it me or am I moving faster on this planet than I normally do? It's one of those things. Passive and a herbivore, so... Oh, ships. Interesting. Corvax word for Corvax, okay, yep, that's probably useful. Just see if we can... see perhaps what direction those ships are going in. Submissive grazing animal, good. And they're the one, and that's the one we already discovered, yeah. Life support systems are taking a bit of a whack. But it's okay though, we got like the size of that thing. Look at the size of it. Oh my god, that's like the size of my ship. This planet, haven't we? It looks great. Very excited to discover more. But we'll do that next episode, I think. But yeah, really excited. Thank you so much, guys, for joining me. Get this little blighter down here first. Hey, you. Let me analyze you. Thank you so much for joining me, and next time we'll explore this planet some more.